and welcome. Thank you so much for watching. This show's all about giving you insights and showcasing brands that help you to live your best life and give you confidence. As always, I want to kickstart your morning with some motivational advice to help you to feel inspired and energized to start your day. Today, I want to talk about why your intentions for others are like a boomerang. The intentions you give out is exactly what you receive in return. The truth is, when we have bad intentions or don't wish others well, that same negative energy is sent back to you. The same way you throw a boomerang and it returns back to us after we throw it is the same way our intentions work. What if I told you that by wishing others well and having good intentions, that we are actually summoning that same energy back to us? This is why it is essential to always wish others well and be happy for the success of others. The harsh reality is that the people who are quote unquote haters only attract negativity because their ill intentions are constantly returning back to them. Wishing people well and celebrating their success is the best and fastest way to attract that same success back to you. Based on the law of attraction, like attracts like. So the more positive intentions you give to others, the more positive energy that will return to you. As Robin Sharma quotes, "To get all that life wants for you, apply what I call the boomerang effect. Give out what you most want to see come back."
Stay tuned. Coming up after the break,
"Jalebi Baby." Like, I mean, that's such a big song. You know, it's for all genres. Even if it comes on the radio, my parents love it. It's just one of those songs that everybody likes. You know, so what inspired that song? And also, let's talk about the collaboration with Jason Derulo. He's also one of my favorite artists. So yeah, how did that come to be?
People always ask me, they're like, why is there salsa elements in there? Why is there like Arabic drums in there? Why is there like an Indian touch to it? And I think it's kind of, I started making music by wanting to combine Indian music and Western music. And that whole love of just combining influences evolved to me wanting to bring in Latin music and different kind of vibes. And, you know, me, I just wanted to make a good song. And for me, making a good song is pulling on different influences because it keeps things exciting.
Wardrobe provided by H&M. Next up on the show, we have the Indo-Canadian rapper Tesher. Tesher is best known for his songs Young Shahrukh and his recent hit single with Jason Derulo, Jalebi Baby. The viral hit Jalebi Baby reached over 100 million views on YouTube. Tesher, thank you so much for being on the show today. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, I'm so excited to have you. And you just said you were in Vancouver, right? You're in Canada.
Yes. Yes, I am. I'm back in the homeland for a limited time only, honestly. I feel like these days I'm just being flown out to different locations to do different things. And it's been enjoyable, but it's been quite the taxing journey on my sleep schedule, to say the least. But no, it's nice to be back in Canada for sure.
I can imagine. And I'm not sure if you see, but we have the CN Tower back here. We're Canadian, so it's always nice to have a fellow Canadian join us. And Tesher, when did you develop a love for music?
Oh man, I feel like I developed my love for music like very shortly after I was born. My family was always really just into music, whether it was just playing it around the house or, you know, my parents being involved in different Indian functions, whether it was like dancing at Vaisakhi, or there's this Indian pavilion for Mosaic, which is a cultural festival we had in the city I grew up in, Regina, Saskatchewan. Or even just like, you know, going to weddings and parties and stuff that was happening in the community. Music was always kind of a constant in our lives. And I think that my parents' like special love for it kind of made me really, made it a big part of my life.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, you mentioned that you grew up in Regina. Was there a strong South Asian influence when you were growing up?
You know, like, yes and no. Our community was, it's a lot bigger now as times have changed and immigration has really gone up. But in those days, it wasn't like how people grow up in, like, you know, Toronto, Brampton, Surrey, Vancouver, stuff where they have, like, a lot of Indian friends. Like, I didn't have pretty much any South Asian friends at all in school, just because there weren't any. Honestly, a funny thing that I'll never forget is like, I made it to the seventh grade in elementary school and I was moving schools. And around that time, my friends found out that I was actually, by Indian, I meant like from India. And they thought I was like Indian as in like indigenous to like Native American, because they just never seen another Indian person. So in those days, it was a little different. There weren't that many Indian people around, but the way that I got that South Asian influence into my life was through, you know, just events that were happening on the weekend, somebody's birthday, somebody's party, going to the mandir on the weekends or the gurdwara or something. There were always little ways, and of course Bollywood movies, there was always little ways that my parents were able to get that into me, even though we didn't have a lot of people my age in the city at that time.
I was gonna say Toronto is filled with Indian people. The GTA, Mississauga, Brampton, there are a lot of Indian people here. So I'm actually surprised to hear that there weren't that many in Regina. And speaking of functions, I know that you used to attend a lot of functions, Indian functions with your dad, and you also were a DJ. So talk to us about that experience and how it kind of helped you develop a love for music as well and your culture.
Yeah, so as the Indian community and South Asian community started to grow in my city, you know, people wanted to get like a videography service done. And so my dad was always into like, he was into like making beats or playing around with computers and stuff, always a very up-to-date guy. And so he had a bit of a passion for videography, and he started to, you know, do the video for people's events. And then they came to him and said, you know, can you do the DJ service as well? And he's like, well, I can't, but my 10, 11-year-old son could probably try. And so at a very young age, my Saturdays kind of consisted of me just like DJing these parties. And I think that lasted up until I like moved. So like until I was like, you know, 16, 17, stuff like that. And that experience kind of teaches you like how to work with a crowd. Mm-hmm. And, you know, now when I listen to music or when I make music, the way that that DJ experience comes into play in my whole process is like, I'll be making a song and I'll be like, oh, that's the part of the song where people are going to hear on the dance floor and they're going to go crazy for it. Yeah. That's what being a DJ kind of teaches you. It teaches you what it teaches you to just think of somebody who's not only somebody who's making music, but somebody who's like trying to please a crowd. And if you can think like that, obviously you can make better records because, you know, you'll just know what'll hit on the dance floor.
Yeah, definitely. And who are some of your musical influences growing up?
Oh, boy. Oh God, so many. I mean, I had the benefit of kind of pulling from both worlds, being Canadian, right? So it was so much, like, I mean, like, 50 Cent, Kanye, Lil Wayne, Drake, Justin Timberlake, a lot of those guys kind of growing up and still till this day. But at the same time, it was, you know, A.R. Rahman, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan, Sukhwinder Singh, Sukhshinder Shinda. So many different people from so many different genres came together to kind of inform my musical sense as it stands today.
And, you know, you've been so successful with your song and, you know, it went viral, really. But before that, I want to talk about, you know, what was your first major big break in the industry?
Oh, boy. You know, it's tough to pinpoint because, like, I spent a lot of, like, the early 2010s where I would make a remix and it would go viral and it would just get picked up on Complex and Hypebeast, MTV, Cosmopolitan. It felt like for like a week, like I would make a remix and then it would go really viral for like a week on the internet. But, you know, it wasn't until I'd say like I think early 2020 where because of TikTok, my song started to really go viral. And it was a remix I had made of Old Town Road and Ramta Jogi, which is a Bollywood song. Which kind of started to go viral on that platform, especially in India. And it's that brought me to TikTok and then helped me help inform my marketing strategy for Young Shahrukh and now, of course, Jalebi Baby.
Yeah, and the Young Shahrukh, I know that got a lot of attention from a lot of Indian celebrities like Alia Bhatt and Ranveer Singh. So how did it feel? Like, what ran through your head when your song started to go viral?
It's a great feeling, you know. Yeah. It's amazing because, and I'm happy it happens now. Yeah. Because I've had years to kind of, like, man, whenever you're starting out making music, I feel like you're really influenced by the people who you like a lot. So the early tracks of me rapping, I don't sound very good, first of all. But, you know, back in high school, I sound like, you know, Kendrick Lamar or Mac Miller, Big Sean. And it took a while for me to find my voice and what I wanted to do for my sense of music. And so the best part about, you know, you talk about Young Shahrukh going viral and seeing, you know, Bollywood celebrities and all these people love it, is that only I could have written that song, and that song is fully about my life. I'm not trying to be anybody else. I'm not trying to sound like anybody else. I'm glad that I went viral for a song that was just me, you know, and that has now continued as I've continued to make music. So if anything, it just felt very validating and just felt good that something that I made with all my heart is succeeding in the world.
and, you know, brings me to Jalebi Baby. Like, I mean, that's such a big song. You know, it's for all genres. Even if it comes on the radio, my parents love it. It's just one of those songs that everybody likes. You know, so what inspired that song? And also, let's talk about the collaboration with Jason Derulo. He's also one of my favorite artists. So, yeah, how did that come to be?
Oh, boy. Well, the initial, like, idea for the song is, like, I just meant... People always ask me, they're like, why is there salsa elements in there? Why is there like Arabic drums in there? Why is there like an Indian touch to it? And I think it's kind of, I started making music by wanting to combine Indian music and Western music. And that whole love of just combining influences evolved to me wanting to bring in Latin music and different kind of vibes. And, you know, me, I just wanted to make a good song. And for me, making a good song is pulling on different influences because it keeps things exciting. But inadvertently, it turned into me making a song that now works across different genres and different audiences. Because now, you know, you could play that song on a Latin radio station and it would work. You could play that on a Bollywood station, it would work. You could play that on a pop station, it could work. So that's kind of the idea. I just wanted to make something dope, and it ended up being something that everybody could like. So lucky for me. As for the Jason Derulo collaboration, like my song had like gone super viral, as you were saying. It was hitting number one in Shazam charts all over the world, especially like Middle East and Europe. Mm-hmm. And I was hitting a point where I'm like, okay, we've hit this point. Wouldn't it be great if, and wouldn't it be special if we could get this song to a point where you could be listening to Canadian radio, like you listening to the radio in Toronto and hearing like Justin Bieber, Ed Sheeran, Tesher, and then Dua Lipa. Like it would just fit in the mainstream. And that too, with a song that has like Hindi Punjabi lyrics in it, that would be a super special big moment. I really wanted to have that happen. And I thought that the most obvious way to make that happen would be through the help of a Western feature artist. And Jason Derulo was somebody I had in mind, but believe it or not, I think I kind of spoke this into existence and manifested it because he reached out to me.
Wow.
He came and he said, yeah, he's like, you know, I love the song. I think he found it through the Shazam charts. He's like, it's so new, so different. He just fell in love with the record and he believed in it enough to want to get involved. And you know, we kind of worked on that record just via Zoom because of COVID at that time. I wasn't able to go to Los Angeles, but we just did the whole thing virtually. And then it was time to do the video and I went down to LA and made it happen.
Wow. I love that you said you manifested it because I've manifested so many things in my life. And my show, my platform is all about inspiration. I basically talk to celebrities and I talk to them about their path to success, the obstacles they faced, and how, you know, they kind of created their own destiny. So I like that you use that word specifically.
Of course, of course.
Yeah. Have you been surprised by your success? I'm sure your parents, you know, Indian parents from Regina, they must be just over the moon. So yeah, let's talk about your success. Like, has it surprised you at all?
You know, I'm so happy that it's happened, but I wouldn't say surprised. Mm-hmm. I'm not surprised because I've worked very hard and I always believed that my music had enough to transcend past the internet and into the mainstream and into people's playlists and stuff. So not surprised we made it, but so incredibly, you know, grateful and happy and thankful that I did make it to this point. As for my parents, yes, no, they've been absolutely been over the moon, overjoyed. Auntie has been calling the house and like offering their thanks. They've been seeing me on the news and stuff. So they're just so thankful. And, you know, my parents were always, I never had parents that were not supportive of me. Mm-hmm. I mean, granted, they said, you know, get your university degree and then you can go screw around and do whatever you want, which I did. But they kind of knew that I always loved music and I was going to do something in this space. And so now, even for them to see me find success, they're so happy too, because they know more than anybody. It's been sleepless nights, years of grinding. So they're happy as well.
Yeah, I love that. I love that your parents were supportive and supported you. Sometimes, you know, if you're not a doctor, lawyer, in one of these conventional fields, you know, the parents get mad. Even for me in journalism, when I first started out, my parents, but you know, once they started to seeing success and they saw how much I loved it and they slowly started seeing, you know, these major milestones, then, you know, then they support. So I love that your parents supported you.
I mean, our parents, like, you know, our Desi Indian parents, South Asian parents, all they want to do is just see us be successful and avoid the hardship that they had to go through. And I think sometimes that kind of comes about in a way that almost seems a bit restrictive, because behind the doctor, lawyer, engineer thing is just them wanting us to not screw up and have a good life. And those are three guaranteed paths to success. Of course, they're going to be a little sketched out when their son says, I want to be a rapper, or their daughter yeah. says, I want to be a journalist, right?
Yeah.
So of course, it's going to come with some risk, but hey, it's up to us to prove them wrong and make them proud, which I think we've done.
yeah, no, definitely. And you know, as I said, my platform's all about inspiration and inspiring the new generation or just anybody, but I want to talk about you. Like, what do you think the secret to your success has been that has really made you stand out from other people? If you can name three traits that has, you know, made you successful, that you think has made you successful, what would you say they are?
Oh my God, okay, three traits. Well, I'd say one, just making art that you want to make, not for anybody else, not trying to make a hit single, not trying to go viral, just making what you think is dope. Because only if you have to be true to yourself, right? Because only you can make what you can make. If you try to make what somebody else is making, it's not going to come about. So this industry, I think, rewards individualism. So you should always try to be yourself, be unique. Another thing would be, I think, staying up to date on how to get the music out. You know, like I was able to recognize that, okay, TikTok is a new thing, and there's a whole way to reach an audience that is a little bit easier than reaching it through YouTube and Instagram platforms that have been around and have become so saturated. So it's good to stay up to date. It's no different than, like, you know, back in the day, the way to get music was to go to the radio station and get them to play your song. Now it's put your stuff on TikTok and put your strategy around that. I think having that is super key. And I think the third thing, if I had to name something, would be to try to be somebody who knows how to do everything, at least a bit of a working knowledge. Like, you should be able to know how to record your own vocals, make your own beats, write your own lyrics, sing your own songs, you know, do your own marketing. Now, I'm not saying don't get help, but when you know how to do everything yourself, you know, you can communicate your vision better, and also you can get things done a little bit quicker. And also cheaper too, which is always good for a starting out artist. So yeah. try to learn as much as you can and have as much, at least a working knowledge of all the things that you need to have a working knowledge of.
Mm-hmm. You know, what you first said, it gave me deja vu, because when I interviewed Seth Rogen, he had said the exact same thing about, you know, make the things that only you can make, be authentic, because that's how you become successful. And I feel like you're very authentic and humble. And, you know, it's nice to see. And I think that's been a part of your success, is being authentic, being humble, and just being who you are. So I think that's great advice. And, you know, for those people, there are so many people that want to be successful. They're putting their music out there. They're doing the right things. You know, they're posting on TikTok, they're using hashtags, they're doing all of that, but they're not seeing the success that they want to. So what would you say to encourage our viewers, for those that are not seeing success and maybe want to give up, what would you say to push them to, you know, kind of keep going?
Well, I'd say one, you know, I think we've all seen that graphic of the person who's digging a tunnel underneath, and right when they're about to give up, they're like, oh, I'm going to give up, but they're this close to hitting the diamond. Yeah. In the mind. So that's sometimes how it is, you know, like I was doing music for 10, 15 years, and only now have I started to see the mainstream success. So, you know, you really just can't give up. You really have to keep going. And, you know, if you've been hustling for a long time and you're not seeing results, you should, don't be scared to change up your approach. You know, like if I kept putting my music only on YouTube the whole time, I don't think I would have gotten to this point. It's because I'm like, okay, in addition to YouTube, let's try TikTok. Let's try Instagram. Let's try making some sort of video content. Let's try to leverage Instagram stories. Always be trying to, like, do new things and different things. Because if you just stick to your one approach and you're doing the same thing over and over again, it's not working. You know, I mean, the joke's on you at that point. You got to be trying new things and being dynamic with your approach.
Mm-hmm. I think that's so true. You have to keep reinventing yourself, keep trying. It's having the same goal, but having different approaches to get the same goal. I think that's so important. Some people keep doing the same thing over and over and they think, why am I not seeing results? But sometimes you just have to change it up, tweak it, go back to the drawing board. And that little bit of change, you know, create success. So I think that's very true. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Because you've been so successful. What's next for you?
Oh man, hopefully more success.
Yes, of course.
I just want to, at this point, it's been so great seeing everybody supporting the music, and I just want to keep making more music, entertaining people. You know, it would be great to just keep going on this trajectory that I have. Maybe maybe, you know, a couple more records in Hollywood, maybe a couple more records in Bollywood, maybe a Bollywood movie, maybe I become an actor, maybe I become something. I have no idea. To be honest, I just want to have fun. I'm happy to have the opportunity to do what I love. So I'm just going to give it my 100% and enjoy the process.
I think that's great. Well, congratulations on all your success. It's so nice to see, you know, that you're still grounded and humble and it hasn't got to your head. You know, sometimes it does. Sometimes, you know, I interview people and yeah. I'm a little surprised, you know, that it's, but you're very humble and I love that. So continue being who you are. And yeah, we hope to have you on the show again soon for your next big break.
Yes, I hope so. Well, thank you so much for having
yeah,
me.
Yeah, thank Take you care. So much. Take care. Bye. Tag TV is available on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple and Android TVs, as well as on Apple and Android phones. Watch us live through YouTube and Facebook.